Hello folks, so in the last video we talked about emitter wrap through or this EWT cell, and we contrasted that to a traditional design, and we realized that you can reduce the amount of shading quite substantially by eliminating these bus bars and these fingers and moving that towards the back of the cell. But at the same time, we also realized that this is a hard a nut to crack. There are many challenges there. You need a very high density of these holes, first of all. Then you need emitter doping to wrap through, and emitter doping to diffuse on all sides of the via. So it's good to scale back our ambition a little bit and take baby steps at time. So the design which is commonly used currently in the industry is this metal wrap through design. So shown here are these two examples of this metal wrap through design, or MWT, and as compared to this EWT design, these designs have slightly larger amount of metal present on the top surface. So you can see that these fingers are still present on the top of the cell, but there are no bus bars. The bus bars are moved behind towards the back of the cell, and you see these holes which are connecting these fingers to the bus bars at the back. And these fingers are, in fact, many a times they are arranged in very nice and beautiful looking patterns. So shown here is one such pattern where you see this fingers at the top arranged in this floral kind of a design, and then there's these holes present which are connecting these fingers to the bus bars which are present at the back. So as compared to the emitter wrap through design, I still have these fingers present here. So I still get 2 to 3% or around 3 to 4% area on the top is covered by this metal lines which give me shading, but it's still less than the 7 to 8% area coverage that you have in a conventional cell. And also it's a much easier process flow, and you don't require as high density of these holes. So the density of these holes is reduced as compared to the emitter wrap through design. And again, one might wonder how do I realize this kind of a design. So it's good to take a peek under the hood and take a look at the cross section of this cell. So it's starts like a conventional cell. So you have this in this case this p-type wafer, and then you diffuse, you form this n plus emitter diffusion at the top. So this would be your n plus diffusion over here, and then you drill holes into this, and you fill it with metal which is contacting the fingers at the top. And now this these fingers are now routed towards the back, towards this p-type bus bar which is located at the back. Similarly, these n-type bus bars are also located at the back. So there can be many, again similar to the emitter wrap through design, there could be many process flow for realizing this metal wrap through scheme. I'm going to give you one example, but this might not be the only way to do it, or even might not be the most efficient way to do it. But one way to do that is to start with the conventional cell process flow. So we form this text ring by a acidic or a wet etch, and then we form this diffusion similar to the way we would do in a conventional cell. So we have this n plus diffusion on the top, and we started with a p wafer, and now what is done is you drill holes. So you drill holes now, and you drill this hole towards the in the cell, and you essentially form this hole and these vias over here. And now the next thing to do is again revert back to the conventional process flow. So this would be again covered with the anti-reflection coating. So let's say this green is my anti-reflection coating, and this will essentially block out this via as well. And then I'll deposit my metal fingers like a normal screen printing kind of a flow. And then when I fire it, what I expect is that this metal will diffuse into this via during that firing process, and it will fill up this via, and I can connect these to form these P plus bus bars at the back. So this is one such process flow, which is closely resemble the conventional process flow. I'm only adding this extra step of drilling this via. And the metal diffuses through this via automatically. I'm hoping automatically during the firing process. So this is, as you can see, it's much more closer to the conventional process flow used for a traditional solar cell. So the metal wrap through design is what is commercially available or is being manufactured by many of these solar cell companies. For example, JA Solar is one of the companies that manufactures this. And similarly, Canadian Solar is another company which manufactures these. So these metal wrap through cells, they are in high volume production currently. And you can easily recognize them by looking at the top surface of these cells. So you'll see these kind of patterns as shown over here. So these dots over here, they resemble the vias. And then you have these fingers, which could be printed in many fashions. For example, over here you see a floral kind of a design, which is used to collect all the current from the emitter and route it through this via towards the bus bar at the back. Similarly, over here you see again many of these holes which are drilled over here, and at the same time you see these fingers in this kind of a design. So there are many kind of a design you could imagine of printing these fingers and holes on this cell. So now I am in a good position to compare these different kind of cell design. So we talked about the conventional cell, which has a front contact and has a back contact. And then we talked about this emitter wrap through and metal wrap through scheme, which minimizes the area at the front surface, which is covered by these contacts, and these bus bars, which are essentially occupy a large percentage of the area, they are now moved towards the back of the cell. And then from the perspective of the shading, the best design is this all back contact cell, where both your N and P kind of contacts are at the back. So in terms of efficiency, this metal wrap through or emitter wrap through cell, it has higher efficiencies as compared to the conventional cell, but it's lower as compared to the all back contact scheme. So this efficiency could be more, you could get up to a 1 percentage point increase in your cell efficiency by using this metal wrap through or emitter wrap through design. And most of that increase, it comes from the increase in the short circuit current, because now you have less shading, so you can collect more of these photons coming from the sunlight. Another increase that people do observe in the cell is increase in the fill factor, and that usually comes from the fact that now you have, since you have moved your bus bar towards the back of your cell, now you can make it much wider. So instead, there's no restriction on the width of this bus bar because it's not causing any shadowing, so you can reduce the I square R loss related to this bus bar, and that improves your fill factor. Another advantage of these back contacted schemes is that they give much better aesthetics. Both these IBC and this EWT MWT cells, they give better aesthetics as compared to the conventional cell. Another major advantage that comes handy when, especially when you're making modules out of these back contacted cells, is that your module assembly becomes much more easier. So in a conventional cell, you have this N contact on the front, and then you have this P contact on the back of the cell. So whenever you're forming a module, you need to connect these NNP contacts, and you need to form these interdigitated bus bars going between these two cells. Whether if you have all the contacts located at the back, you could use a module assembly very similar to what is used in the chip industry, where you just take these cells and mount them on top of this printed circuit, and you just take these cells and mount it over here. There is no need to essentially take wires from one cell and connect it to another cell. So it makes the whole module assembly much easier, well, and that's another advantage you get both from these emitter wrap through and middle wrap through, and also this all back contact kind of scheme.